Hello students, welcome to the lesson 17 of chapter 3 from the subject Advanced Structural Analysis. So in this lesson, we will continue the problem from the fitness transformation approach, rigid jointed frame, non-sway type. So in the previous lesson, we have already done the complete problem in part 1, right? Here what we'll do is, we'll see how we develop the force transformation matrix B. There I have given the direct result. So here we'll see step-by-step procedure on how to do it and draw the bending moment and shear force diagram. Okay. This was the problem. We got this as the final moments, right? Now, with the final moments obtained, first we'll plot the bending moment diagram. In order to plot the bending moment diagram, write the free bending moment diagram for BC and then free bending moment diagram for AD. This will be what? UDL over entire span for WL square by 8. So 9 into 5 square by 8. Here it will be what? WL by 4. So 60 into 6 by 4. So the results will be, this will be 28.125 kilonewton meter, will be 90 kilonewton meter. Okay, now let us plot it. So in order to plot, let us put the end moments. So this, all end moments are negative, that's why they are hogging. Okay, we have to use the hogging and sagging concept. So AB and BA should hog the beam. Hog means lift it up, so the directions will come like this. Next, this also should lift it up, so this direction will be like this. Okay, so what are the values? 55.537, 62.27, 39.92. See, at joint B it is same, so all units are in kilonewton meter. Now let's draw the bending moment diagram. So it will be like this. So here it's going up, 62, here it's 39, here again 62, here it is 55.37, 62.27, 62.27, 39.92. So this is bending moment because of final end moments, which will connect using the straight lines like this. Okay, it will be straight line. Figures are not to the scale. Now along with this free bending moment, it is UDL, so it will be a parabola. Okay, so like this parabola, that is 28.125 kilonewton meter, and here it is in the form of a triangle point load, so linear like this and linear like this, so it is 90, so it's come above 90 kilonewton meter. Negative, positive, negative. This will be negative. This will be positive. This is what your bending moment diagram. This portion is your frame portion, what you have. Okay. Right. Now, once the bending moment diagram is drawn, now let us draw the shear force diagram. Okay. In order to draw shear force diagram, we first have to find reactions. Just take loadings on this and try to find the reaction. So here you have what? 60 kilonewton and 6 meters. This is 3 meters and 3 meters. And here you have a UDL. UDL over entire span. So this is 9 kilonewton meter. So this is 5 meters. See, the reactions what we obtained here in the fixed end moments will be different. Here we take only the loading and find the reaction. Okay, but here when we come here, we'll take the fixed end moments also and then find the reaction. So that reaction, this reaction will not be same. Be careful with that. Okay, so this is A, B, C, this is R, A, this is R, B, 1, this is R, B, 2, this will be R, C. Okay, now consider first span A, B, sum of vertical forces equal to 0, all upward forces positive. So it will be what? RA plus RB 1 minus 60 equal to 0. Then sum of moment about A equal to 0, all clockwise forces positive. So it will be what? This is anticlockwise, so minus 55.37 plus 60 into 3 plus 62.27 minus RB1 into 6 equal to 0. The RA is passing through A, so it will not cause any moment. Okay. So your RB1 answer will be 186.9 divided by 6. So that's equal to 31.15 kilonewton. Okay. Substitute it here. You will get the value of RA. 660 minus 31.15. If you do, you get the answer. It will give us 28.85 kilonewton. These are the proof reactions. Now let us do it for BC. Again do summation of vertical forces equal to 0, all upward forces positive. So it will be RB2 plus RC is minus 9 into 6 is equal to 0. Then sum of moment about B equal to 0, all clockwise forces positive. So it will be what? Minus 62.27 plus 9 into 6 into 6 by 3 plus 39.92 clockwise minus RC into 6 anticlockwise. This is 5. Okay, so it's 5. This is also 5. It is 5 equal to 0. So let's do the calculation. Minus 62.27 plus 9 into 5 into 5 by 2 plus 39.92. You will get RC is equal to 90.15 by 5. This will be equal to 18.03 kilonewton. Substitute it here, you will get your value of RB2. So 18.03 minus 9 into 6. So it's 35.97. Now let us draw the shear force diagram. Okay. RA upwards. Okay, so this much. How much is RA? 28.85. No load between A and that point. So it will be linear. Then come down by 60. Okay. Total will be 60. This is already 28.85. So how much will this be? 31.15. Left up is positive, here right up negative. So negative equal to RB1, that is 31.15, again linear, join here. Okay, so this will be negative. This will be the shear force diagram for span AB. Now let us do for BC. Left up is again positive, so RB2 value is up, that is 35.97. Then right up is negative, so it will come down 18.03, and wherever there is UDL, your shear force is linear, so it will come linearly like this. Linear. Okay, so this is your positive, this is your negative portion. So this is how your shear force diagram will look for the given frame. Okay, so this is your frame. Whatever I am doing in the green, that is your frame. Okay. SFD will look okay. Now SFD and BMD is over. Now how we have calculated this force transformation matrix, that will be seen. In the previous problem, I directly gave this. Now I'll show one by one how we'll get this. Okay. But first let us do for x1. x1 equal to 1. Where is our x1? If you remember in the diagram, x1 is vertically up here. x2 is what? Horizontal, and x3 is what? Clockwise movement. Okay, so let's do one by one. X1, what we have to do to get the x1 row is, we have to apply, take this frame. Here we have to give the direction of x1. Here x unit load we have to give. So 1. If I apply it here like this, here no movement, here no movement, here no movement, but here there will be a movement. So 1 into this distance is 5 meters. So 1 into 5 will be the movement. 5. Okay, that's 5. But what will be the direction? You have to always take resisting. Okay. Resisting moment. So if this is creating clockwise, so the resisting moment will be what? We'll need an anti-clockwise moment. 1 into 5 is nothing but 5. Now we shall write the values here. You always have to compare it with the local coordinates. So where are your local coordinates? See here. These are your local coordinates. Okay. We'll put the local coordinates here so that it will be easy for us to refer. Okay. 3. This is 4. Compare this with this. Okay. Direction is correct. Clockwise. So this is resisting. This should be anti-clockwise. Clockwise it is creating. So we have to put the resisting as I told. So it will be anti-clockwise. Now you compare at A no movement, B no movement, but at C there is a movement, and if you compare the directions, they both are same direction. So it will be 0, 0, 0 and 5. This is how you write. Okay. What we have to do? We have to apply unit force and then check what will happen to the moments in the local coordinates. Okay. Next, let us do x2 equal to 1. So here x2 is what? Horizontal force. Like this. Let's take the frame A, B, C. Let us take horizontal. So this is equal to 1. Now here there will be no movement. When it comes here, it is creating anti-clockwise. So here resisting movement will be clockwise. Okay. Again here also it will be anti-clockwise. Here when it is here like this, it is creating in this direction, anti-clockwise direction. So the resisting will be in clockwise direction. Let me write all the values. So force into perpendicular, so 1 is the force, perpendicular distance is 6. This is 5. This will be what? 6 into 1. So there is 6. Here also it will be 6. Here when it comes to this point, this is also 6. Okay, this is also 6. Understood. Now you do the comparison for the directions for the local coordinates. Here at A, there is no value, so it is 0. Coming to B, here it is opposite directions. So minus 6, minus 6. Coming at C, again in opposite direction. So we'll have again minus 6. Understood. This is how you do for x2. Now one more thing. If you observe, when we are doing this w1, w2, w3, w4, w2 is similar to in clockwise. Sorry, w1. W1 is similar to what? Your x2. If you observe. So whatever you get for your x2 is valid for your w1. Okay. So what you can do, instead of calculating, we'll write w1 is equal to 1, same. Observe here, it is 0, minus 6, minus 6 and minus 6. Because the directions are same. You don't have to do it again. Next. Now this is finished, this is finished. Now let us do for x3. X3 equal to 1. If there is any coordinate in the direction of x3, let us see. Here also w2 is in clockwise at A. Okay, so x3 and w2 are similar. Right, so x3 and w2 are same. We'll do for one, we'll get the same for the other one also. Okay, this and this. let's start doing that. So fixed support here, we'll take this. This is A, B, C, right? Now we have to apply a unit clockwise direction moment. So this is one. Whenever you apply a moment, that moment will be same for the entire cantilever portion. So same will be there up to the point C. There is a bend, but it's like a cantilever portion only. So what will happen? Whatever moment is here, that will be transferred up to the point C. So if it is like this here, it will be like this here, it will be like this here, and it will be like this here. So all will be one. Moment will not have any perpendicular distance. So here it's one, here it's one, here it's one. So understood. Moment is same throughout. Everywhere it's one. Compare it with the coordinates of your local coordinates. So if you observe, the directions are same for all the values. Directions are same. So here it will be 1, 1, 1 and 1. So if you observe here, 1, 1, 1, 1. Similar to that we got for W2. Got it? Now, let us do it for W3 equal to 1. So let's take this frame. Check where is your W3. This is your C. How is the direction of W3? Here. It is vertical downwards at B. So here vertical downward at B equal to 1. Here it will be 0, here it will be 0, here also it will be 0. When it comes to here, this is creating anti-clockwise movement, but the resisting will be in clockwise direction. So that will be what? 1 into 5, so that's 5. Now you compare with the local coordinates. Only at 4 you have different direction, right? So it will be minus. All other three will be 0, 0, 0, 0 and minus 5. Understood? Now the last one is what? The last one is W4 equal to 1. So it is very simple. This is your frame A, B, C. There is W4. Direction what we have? Clockwise at D. So here you apply a clockwise moment at D. Equal to 1. If it's 1, this portion will not have any effect. Only for this portion we have to take it. Okay. Here it will be like this. So this will be 1. So at A and what? 1 and coordinate, 2 coordinate, it will not have anything. So at 3 and 4 coordinate, you will have the values. And if you observe, the directions are same. Okay. So it will be 0, 0, 1 and 1. Understood. This is how you will get your force transformation matrix. Okay, that's your BX and BW. In every coordinate you have to apply the unit force and you see what moments have been developed and then compare it with the local coordinates to get the directions and then write it. Okay, so this is how you do the problem. These are corresponding to local coordinate 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, hope you understood it. Thank you.